Hey everybody, I am going to be doing the video that I said I was going to do, I think in my last eBay video, and that's talk about why I am so passionate about selling of designer replicas or just counterfeit items in general. Now, the reason why I wanted to talk about this video was because of a comment that somebody left me on my video called Poshmark, The Good, The Bad, and The Ugly. I think that's what I titled it. And I said, I don't remember my exact word for word that I said in that video, but I did say somewhere in there that when I see listings that say not authentic, not real, fake, whatever, something like that, I report those listings because it is illegal to sell them in the United States. Now, from my research that I have done, it is not illegal to purchase them in the United States. Now, in other countries, it is illegal to purchase, so I just wanted to throw that out there. That's based on my research. There are people trying to get the laws changed in the United States to make it illegal to purchase. Now, the reason why I am so passionate, I will get to in just a minute, but somebody by the name of Sarah, I'm not going to give her complete username, and YouTube sent her comment to spam so no one else can see it, but I'm going to read her comment, and I've got my computer right here. Excuse me for looking down. The reason why I said I was going to read her comment, I wanted to say a disclaimer, I'm not offended by the comments directed at me personally. I'm not offended at all. A faceless person, you know, there's a face on her. I don't know that it's really her. I don't know that Sarah is her real name. Somebody leaving me a rude comment like that 2 years ago, I would have been upset. At this point in time, you get a mental eye roll. That's pretty much it. But I was offended by her ignorance. And when I say ignorance, it doesn't mean I'm calling that person stupid at all. It just means somebody that is ignorant on a certain topic, a certain whatever. I'm ignorant about a lot of things. You don't want me doing brain surgery on you. I'm very ignorant about something like that. So when I say ignorance, it's just ignorance on a certain topic. But I felt that it was offensive. And before someone makes a comment like this, they should do their research. And if they feel after doing the research that they are still right about it, more power to you. But let me read her comment. Let me read Sarah's comment. It starts off as, not everyone can afford a $1,000 to $3,000 bag. And if these people are saying in their listings that they are replicas or fakes, then they're just being honest about it at least. And I think it was pretty crappy of you to actually go to the designer and report them when they're just trying to sell what they have in their being honest about it. And it's pretty crappy of you. And I honestly hope no one buys from your store ever again because that was just so messed up. These people are being honest. Yeah, they may not be real, but they still are trying to sell it. They were honest about it not being real. If they lied about it, it's a different story. For you to go so far as you did, that is just ridiculous. And for that, I wish you the worst luck at selling because you screwed over people that were just trying to sell what they had. And it was, and that's hard. I'm sorry. There's no punctuation in here. There's not a single comma, period, or anything, so it's hard for me to read this. And that's horrible. So with that said, I'm sure you have not followed every single law in your whole entire life that kind of makes you a hypocrite in that way and have no respect for you at all. So number one, there was one period in that whole sentence, and that was at the end. So it was one entire run-on sentence, no commas, misspelled words galore. So Sarah, your writing was also offensive. I will say that the way you write, your grammar was offensive. Okay. Now I'm just being snippy right there. Sorry about that. But, let me get my scarf. I just put my computer on it. So the reason why I'm so passionate, it's not because, let's say someone can't afford a $1,000 to $3,000 bag. Let me just say, it took me years to be able to buy a Louis Vuitton handbag. I have one Louis Vuitton handbag, and it literally took me years before I got it. I just didn't run out and get it. I saved up, and then really thought hard about it and made a decision that that was a purchase that I wanted to do. Now, when I was much younger, I didn't realize the repercussions of buying a counterfeit item. I was ignorant back then when I was a teenager, but I have since learned. And I do realize that a lot of people out there want designer items and they don't want to pay a huge amount. I get it. And if you don't want to pay a huge amount, don't do it. No one's making you do it. But don't in turn go and buy a counterfeit item. And I'm getting to why it's so bad. But I just don't want it to come across as me saying, I don't think you should have that. That's not it at all. If you want to get an item, get it, but get a authentic one. Is it ridiculous that the designers charge so much for pieces? Absolutely, it's ridiculous, okay? I buy a lot of designer items. I still think the prices are ridiculous, but the majority of my designer items I have gotten on sale. Not all of them, but the majority of them I have gotten on sale. So if you wait, you can get brand new ones on sale, or you can buy pre-loved, real, authentic items. So, if you do any research whatsoever, I will put some links below to sites that I found. You can just Google problems with buying counterfeit designer handbags, legalities of it, things of that nature, and you can find so many topics. It is a very controversial issue. Some people are 100% for buying counterfeit items because they're thinking, and I understand the thought process that a $1,000 handbag is absolutely ridiculous. I am not going to pay that, but yet I still like the logo on it, so I'm going to go get a counterfeit one. I kind of get the mindset on that the price is ridiculous, but yet you still want it, so why not buy something that looks exactly alike, like it for $100 instead of $1,000? I get that, but you need to do some research before you make that decision. There's a book called Black Market Billions out there, and it talks about counterfeit items, not only about designer purses, designer sunglasses, it talks about other things that are being counterfeited. Brakes that go on your cars, airplane parts. Do you really want those to be counterfeit? Absolutely not. Counterfeit items are hurting people. They do baby formulas get counterfeited, stolen from stores, and then they add horrible ingredients to them and resell them. Things that are stolen are medicines. They're allowed, you know, they go out of date and then they're resold. Those are not counterfeited per se, but they're stolen, yet you don't know the expiration date on them. You buy them, you take them, you get sick, or if you take them to get better, then you don't get better. And also, money from these items, and it has been talked about over and over and over in these sites, this book, goes to support terrorism, it goes to support human trafficking, child prostitution. This is what counterfeit items and stolen items go to support. We will never ever really know the damage, the full, you know, comprehensive damage of this market, because, you know, it is on the black market. There's no way on the face of this earth to really get those statistics. So I suspect what has been reported is just barely the tip of the problem. I did print some things out. And so two different sites that I saw, this is in France. I'm not 100% sure that this is true, but I have seen it on two different sites. One was a report that went on the Today Show, and the lady that was talking worked for a fashion magazine. I can't remember which one. So she reported it. Then I found it on another site that says, if you, as a consumer, are spotted with a fake handbag, or fake designer handbag in France, you can be fined up to 300,000 euros and could get up to 3 years in prison. So that seems very extreme on the front end, saying, hey, I got a fake Louis, I go to France, it's spotted by the local authorities. That seems extreme. But when you think, really seriously think about where that money is going, child prostitution, human trafficking, terrorism, is that really that severe of punishment? I mean, come on, child prostitution. You think it's okay to sell a fake designer bag and that money is going to support child prostitution, terrorism, human trafficking? This is why I get so passionate and angry about it and just get offended by people like Sarah's comments. Again, she can say whatever she wants to about me. It doesn't hurt me that she wishes me ill will. I don't care. It doesn't mean anything to me. But where it means is the fact that she thinks it's okay in a roundabout way to support terrorism, to support human trafficking, to support child prostitution, to support fake airplane parts where the airplane could crash and could kill people. This is why I'm so passionate, as you can probably see it right now. I just get riled up about it, is the fact that her ignorance and other people like her continuously supports these things, and it just makes me angry. And I'm not trying to be controversial whatsoever, but I'm like, please, please, please do your research before you buy. You go to a flea market, you see a Coach bag out there for $20. It's not real, okay? You can still get authentic Coach bags for that price. I have sold them on Poshmark and eBay for that price, okay? And they are real authentic, I promise. My Coach bags are real and authentic, okay? So I will try to link below these sites, but just some other things. Just the amount of revenue that is lost to your particular country. The United States loses billions of dollars of revenue, tax money a year. People lose jobs because of this. It hurts everybody. Don't just think that somebody who has a Poshmark site or an eBay site, they're in their house, they're a good person. They have, you know, a few fake Louis or Coach bags to sell. They're trying to make a few hundred dollars, trying to do, you know, benefit themselves. I get it, but they are not realizing, at least I hope they're not realizing, that what they are contributing to is horrible, horrible stuff. And they need to realize it. If they do go into that consciously thinking, yeah, it supports child prostitution, but hey, I want to make $100, I don't care, then that is a horrible person. Yes, I said it. So I just wanted to throw this out there. There are so many websites that can tell you more than I can, but it is a, you know, according to the law, I'm looking right here, it is a trademark infringement, and it says, you know, the site I'm looking at, it says in New York City, trademark counterfeiting is a Class C felony, and it says it's the same category as car theft. But think about this, car theft is bad. Yes, it is. But it's not child prostitution, it's not human trafficking, it is not terrorism. I think the laws need to be increased on this and made stronger. So, just throwing it out there, I'm very passionate on this topic. You may disagree with me, fine, but please, please, please do your own research before you think that selling a fake Louis is acceptable. Just do your research. So, just throwing that out there whatsoever. And on the note of her accusing me of committing crimes, I have never stolen a car. I want to throw that out there. I have gotten a speeding ticket before. There's my crime, I confessed. So on that note, no, I don't run around and break laws all the time. I have speeded, I've gotten a ticket. Okay, that's my crime. So I just thought I would throw that out there. And I wish all of you would get as passionate about it as I am. And if we all come together as a society, as citizens of whatever country you belong to, and stop selling and stop buying, hopefully we can stop this from happening and stopping the support of terrorism, human trafficking, child prostitution, stop people from losing their jobs over things like this. So that's why I'm so passionate. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you weren't offended, but if you are, it makes me wonder why you got offended over this topic. So I hope that if you were offended for the same reasons that I am. So on that note, if you want to unsubscribe to me because of this and wish me ill will, go for it. I am still passionate about this topic. So on another note, my videos will go back to their normal fluff that they are of outfits of the days and haul videos and things like that. I will get back to those. So talk to you guys later. Bye, everybody.